The Philippine government will seek the release of convicted drug mule Mary Jane Veloso once repatriated. Manila's Foreign Office says it will make this appeal with Indonesia after Jakarta decided Veloso could serve the remainder of her life sentence back in the Philippines. The agency says Veloso could likely be home before Christmas. Filipino-Indonesian authorities, however, have yet to determine an official schedule and a location for where Veloso would be detained. The Filipino has been on death row in Indonesia since 2010. She has remained in jail nearly a decade since her life was spared at the last minute following pleas by the Philippines. ASEAN defense ministers call for an early completion of a code of conduct in the South China Sea. This appeal is contained in a joint declaration issued after their ministerial meeting in Laos. The declaration pushes for a peaceful resolution of disputes in accordance with international law. It also calls for self-restraint in activities that would escalate disputes. ASEAN and China have already spent 6 years negotiating a code of conduct for the South China Sea. China, the Philippines, and several other ASEAN states have competing claims in the disputed waters. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. is set to travel to the United Arab Emirates for a one-day working visit next week. According to the Presidential Communications Office, Mr. Marcos will meet with UAE President Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed Al Nahyan and Abu Dhabi on November 26th. Now, the PCO said the dialogues between the leaders will lead to agreements that will deepen the Philippine-UAE relations. It adds that although the visit will be short, it will create opportunities that are substantial. Marcos will be flying with a lean team, as the delegation has been trimmed down to a minimum. Philippine authorities step up security for the first family following threats made by Vice President Sara Duterte. Katrina Domingo has tonight's top story.
May kinausap na ako na tao. Sinabi ko sa kanya, kapag pinatay ako, patayin mo si BBM, si Lisa Araneta, at si Martin Romales. No joke. No joke. Nagbilin na ako, ma'am. Pag namatay ako, sabi ko, huwag ka tumigil ha, hanggang hindi mo mapatay sila. And then he said yes.
Vice President Sara Duterte repeatedly underscored that she was not joking when she claimed to have contracted an individual to terminate President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., First Lady Liza Marcos, and Speaker Ferdinand Martin Romualdez should she be killed amid the worsening political squabble between her and the administration. The vice president gave this statement in an online video conference while she stayed inside the detention room of her chief of staff, Attorney Zulaika Lopez, inside the Batasang Pambansa. Shortly after House officials ordered Lopez's transfer to a correctional facility. Malacanang did not take Duterte's words lightly, with Executive Secretary Lucas Bersamin ordering the Presidential Security Command to hike the chief executive's security. The palace says any statement against the president's safety is treated as an active threat. In a separate statement, the Presidential Security Command says it has heightened and strengthened security protocols for the president and the first family. The PSC adds that it treats with utmost seriousness any threats to the life of the president, especially one made so brazenly. Political analyst Edmund Tayo says Duterte's threats may be a tactic to shift the public's attention away from congressional investigations into her office's alleged misuse of confidential funds. Tayo says officials, including Duterte, should answer all allegations hurled against them instead of just continuously blame-shifting.
My advice is to answer this allegation fairly and squarely. Ang problema dito, hindi na nga nasasagot yung issue, magbabato ka pa ng ibang issue. So iniiba yung usapan eh, yun ang nangyayari.
For Senate President Francis Escudero, the Vice President should review whether her recent remarks truly serve the Filipino people. He called on those close to the Vice President to advise her against making such statements that neither benefit her nor her office. Escudero is also calling on all parties involved to ease tensions to prevent further harm and to avoid diverting attention from urgent issues requiring the government's focus. Former Senator and former Police Chief Panfilo Lacson issued a similar appeal. He said someone should intervene between the warring camps and push for a ceasefire as the Philippines should focus on more important work. In the midst of all these politicking, the Armed Forces of the Philippines asserts that it remains to be a professional organization duty-bound to protect the public and the state. AFP Chief Romeo Bronner Jr. assures the public that the AFP will remain true to the Constitution and the chain of command. Katrina Domingo, ABS-CBN News.
House Assistant Majority Leader Representative Zia Alonto Adiong calling for heightened security measures for the first couple and the President's cousin, House Speaker Ferdinand Martin Romualdez. This comes after the statements of Vice President Duterte threatening the safety of the country's top leaders. Adiong maintains Duterte's rhetoric should not be taken lightly and called her outburst reckless and destabilizing. He also urged Duterte to retract her statements and clarify her intentions. It's not just threats against people's lives, but Vice President Sara Duterte accused the House Speaker of lining his pockets with public funds and benefiting from illegal activities. Cassandra Salonga has this story.
Ninyong lahat, Martin Romualdez, Lisa Marcos, Bongbong Marcos, ginigit-git nyo yung mga tao ko dyan sa envelope na yan.
Vice President Sara Duterte fired off a string of accusations against First Lady Lisa Marcos and House Speaker Martin Romualdez. Her tirade, sparked by the transfer order for Chief of Staff Attorney Zulaika Lopez to the Women's Correctional Facility in Mandaluyong. Lopez was detained at the house after being cited in contempt for alleged evasiveness concerning the Office of the Vice President's confidential funds. In her virtual press briefing, the country's second highest official stated that her political enemies have crossed the line.
Hindi pa kayo nakakita ng kalaban katulad ko. Nagpigil ako na nagpigil kasi masama sa bayan. Hindi maganda ang political instability. Pinabayaan ko kayo sirain ng sirain ang pangalan ko kasi I have nothing to lose. Sinira niyo na siya. Wala na siyang ikakasira pa. Tapos ganito ang gagawin niyo.
She also questioned the competence of President Marcos as a leader and accused him of being deceitful.
Nagpresenta ka na magiging presidente ka. Tapos hindi ka pala marunong. Sarap-sarap ng kain ninyo, buffet, alak, lahat. Pero yung taong bayan, na pinamisan ninyo ng 20 pesos na rice, yung taong bayan na hindi ninyo pinupuntahan sa mga komunidad nila, ano sabi nila? Asin lang, okay na mi, anad naman mi, anak. Ganyan ang bayan natin.
The Vice President also accused the House Speaker of meddling with DepEd's funds for his personal gain.
Paano nyo ginagil ang pera ng Department of Education? Martin Romualdez. Inattach nyo ang projects na hindi man lang dumaan sa paaralan, sa SDS, sa region, even sa central office. Basta na lang listahan ng mga congressman. 19 billion. Kinuha nyo ang 5 billion sa repairs, nilipat nyo para mukhang lumaki ang pera.
But it didn't stop there. Duterte claims Romualdez is also benefiting from illegal activities, including pogo operations and smuggling. The Vice President, however, did not offer any proof to back her allegations.
Tanggap ka sa illegal, tanggap ka sa pogo. Pinaalis niyo lahat ng kompetisyon ninyo, naiiwan ang pogo mo. Tanggap ka, pogo. May nagsasabi pa, tumatanggap ka sa smuggling, sa droga. Tapos kuha ka dito sa National Treasury. Akin ito, babawiin ko lahat.
In the press conference lasted over 2 hours, Duterte berated lawmakers to stop what she calls the persecution of her office.
Nagpipigil ako eh. Kasi gusto ko lang magtrabaho. Gusto ko lang tapusin nyo na yung show ninyo dyan sa House of Representatives para makabalik na kami sa trabaho namin.
Cassandra Salonga, ABS-CBN News.
The Criminal Investigation and Detection Group is directed to investigate Duterte's assassination threat. PNP Chief General Romel Francisco Marbil says threats against the security of the president and all public officials are no laughing matter. Marbil adds, the president's safety is a national concern and must be addressed with the highest level of urgency. Philippine House lawmakers slammed the vice president's latest tirades against President Marcos Jr. They challenged the vice president to stop deflecting the issue and face questions about her confidential expenses. Harleen Delgado reports.
Vice President Sara Duterte earned the ire of lawmakers in the House of Representatives following her profanity-laced rant and serious threat against President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., First Lady Liza Araneta Marcos, House Speaker Martin Romualdez, and other House members. For House Assistant Majority Leader Representative Jay Conghun, Duterte's recent outburst is merely a diversionary tactic. He adds the public should not lose sight of the issue, which is the alleged misuse of confidential funds of both the Office of the Vice President and Education Department during Duterte's tenure. Taguig Representative Pammy Zamora echoes this assessment. She said no amount of distraction should divert attention from ferreting out the facts behind the use of confidential funds. Zamora also challenged Duterte to just appear before the House Committee on Good Government and Public Accountability to clear the issue. The panel is set to resume hearings on Monday, November 25. At least one lawmaker has called out Duterte's recent actions. In a statement, Partalist Representative Jude Acidra said Duterte's toxic behavior reflects poorly on her role as the second highest official of the land. For Acidra, the vice president should just explain her confidential expenses. Meantime, the panel's chairman, Representative Joel Chua, rejects Duterte's accusations that their transfer order put her chief of staff in harm's way. Chua also questioned Duterte's decision to stand as the legal counsel of her chief of staff. He declined to comment on whether this merits an impeachment complaint.
Under the Constitution, the President, the Vice President, the members of the Cabinet are prohibited from practicing their profession. So I do not know where the Vice President is getting this idea that she can stand as counsel for Attorney Lopez. Maybe they're just using this as an excuse to for her to be able to join Attorney Lopez.
But when asked if the vice president's threat against Marcos and Romualdez could be a possible ground for impeachment, Chua answered in the affirmative. Harleen Delgado, ABS-CBN News.
Vice President's Chief of Staff, Attorney Zuleika Lopez, is back at the Veterans Memorial Medical Center in Quezon City. The House ordered her return to the state-run facility after her brief stay at St. Luke's Medical Center this morning. Lopez fell ill after being ordered to transfer to a prison facility. Now at St. Luke's, an emotional Lopez clung to the vice president as her transfer order was read by the head of the Criminal Investigation and Detection Group, Brigadier General Nicolas Torre III. According to the PNP, there is still no order when Lopez will be sent to the Women's Correctional. Meanwhile, the House Sergeant-at-Arms accuses Vice President Duterte of blocking the lawful transfer of her chief of staff to the correctional facility. Police Major General Napoleon Taas also said Duterte physically intervened to prevent the serving of the transfer order.
The vice president's intervention came during a visit to the House detention facility, which had been initially permitted under specific guidelines. Instead of adhering to those parameters, the VP escalated the situation by overstaying her visit and ignoring repeated directives from the Sergeant-at-Arms to leave the premises. She then locked herself inside the office of Davao City Representative Paolo Duterte, prompting a lockdown of the entire House premises.
The vice president maintains politics is behind efforts to harass her subordinate. Duterte also says there are threats to her safety and she already knows who may order her killing.
Tinatanong niya ako kanina, that is the same question that Yusek Lopez asked me, do you trust them? And then I said, I do not trust anyone anymore ngayon. Ganun yung concern ko sa safety and security ko, but then they just dismiss it as if...
Kaya niyo po nagawa yung statement na parang pag binangyari sa akin, nagbilin na po kayo dun sa...
Yes, nagbilin talaga ako. Sabi ko, pag binatay ako, alam na natin, wala na namang iba eh. Sino mag gusto magpatay kayo ni Sara? Diyos ko.
Duterte ally Senator Ronald De La Rosa believes dirty politics is behind efforts to pressure the office of the vice president. De La Rosa also calls the transfer order for Attorney Lopez unjustified. He argues there has been no case filed yet against Duterte's chief of staff. The senator adds Lopez should be allowed to stay at a hospital to receive proper medical attention.
Para sa akin, it's a very unfortunate dahil yung tao na hindi pa man lang nagiging accused, no? Hindi pa napaila ng kaso. Kung i-treat mo parang convictado na dadalhin mo sa Women's Correctional Facilities, a place for convicted criminals. That's the worst for me na ikulong mo isang taong cited in contempt lang.
An oil price hike looms in the last week of November. Estimates show a liter of gasoline could be more expensive by up to 1 peso and 30 centavos, while that of diesel could go up by as much as 1 peso and 20 centavos. The price per liter of kerosene, meanwhile, is expected to go up by at least 70 centavos. The Energy Department earlier attributed this markup to the worsening war in Ukraine and the depreciation of the Philippine peso.